Obviously, being a part of soil, it's a pleasure for me to be here on this special day. We created soil with certain dreams, and we are happy that you are carrying forward those dreams. So at the very outset, let me congratulate you, the graduating students, and also thank on your behalf and on my own behalf your parents and well-wishers for supporting your education. At soil, you have learned many things, but I hope you will remember three messages of soil. One is mindfulness, second is empathy, and third is sustainability. Amongst many others, I think these three you must remember all the time as you go into practice of leadership. When you embark on the journey of leadership, question arises, what is expected of leadership? As I feel, leadership is judged by the positive impact it makes on the organization that you serve, on the community that you serve, and the society that you serve. So therefore, you have to decide what is the legacy that you want to leave behind, and what is the positive impact that you want to make. That is what will decide what journey you want to take. Other thing you have to remember is that when you enter this world of leadership at this juncture, you will face an environment where the only certainty will be uncertainty. Therefore, you will have to manage and make decisions about leadership in an area of uncertainty. And for taking wise decision in the era of uncertainty, I think you need a trained mind, which is trained in critical inquiry, independent thinking, and intellectual flexibility. If you have these three things, then you'll be able to appreciate the different perspectives, make connection out of those perspectives, and make some sense out of that, which will then guide you to make the right decisions for your organizations and for yourself. When you make these decisions, you'll have to ultimately make good decisions. And to me, the definition of good decision is that decision which is good and fair to all concerned. And I always believe that if you have to make good and fair decisions, the four-way test of Rotary International might be handy. It says, ask yourself four questions. Is it the truth? Is it fair? Will it build goodwill? And will it be beneficial to all concerned? I think you follow this test, and slowly you develop a practice of making wise decisions. And ultimately, only when you make wise decisions, you will become the wise leaders. And I only hope all of you will be the wise leaders. But as you climb the ladder of leadership, let me give you some advice as an old person. Number one, be yourself. Be your natural self. Follow your natural instincts. Listen to everybody, but be yourself. Number two, remain humble. Because if you are humble, nobody can hurt your ego. That will help you. Number three, believe in some superpower, doesn't matter who it is. Because then that will act as a moral compass, your inner voice will act as a moral compass. And fourth, don't give up your goal of happiness for short-term gains. Thank you very much.